about this heat warning.
Got a couple Argos jersey cards last box. Hope this one's even better.
Let's try this.
They're humans.
And people said, why do you still do that? Well, we still do that.
People are retarded, that's fine. Stupid people out there. Sad, really.
One of them out of BC in Vancouver, and another one in Burlington. Now,
un peu en retard, comme on dit en français.
This is really bad, just given, and I'm oftentimes the one who says, you know, we're all human, we all make mistakes, and I know that typically the counter-argument is that there's certain individuals in certain positions.
First pack right off the bat, Chevon Walker, Ottawa Red Blacks autograph card.
This time. An RCMP officer leaving his four children in a car.
For half an hour,
says he was checking on them. The reason he did it was because he had to go to work. I think it was the courthouse, so I'm going to assume that. Yeah, he had to testify probably. His babysitter canceled the last second. So he left him in the car. I mean,
Swayze Waters.
Procedures. You can phone the prosecutor and say you're unable to attend, I suppose. He probably didn't want to have that. But I'd have been more tempted.
Tory Gurley, star rookie, strong Argos.
Yeah. With me, and again, I know that you're not a big talker. Can you keep an eye on them, though?
Yeah.
Now, this one was in a parkade, and the reporter, you know, heard muffled crying. She followed the sound from the TV, saw four young children, including a baby, inside the vehicle. She said all the kids appeared to be under the age of 7.
Austin Collie.
The door to the SUV was unlocked.
That is crazy as well. Right? I mean, aside from whatever...
Dexter McCoy, All-Stars.
...the stress a child can get in, the kidnapping of a child is a real potential as well.
So the dad says he did check in on them, and apparently there's no real rules in place about, you know, what age you should leave kids unattended, that sort of stuff. The RCMP saying they're aware
base pack.
Of the incident. They're taking a look into it. They have no further information at this time.
Mm-hmm.
But then there's a story out of Burlington, and they're still investigating the cause of death. But a 3-year-old boy was found in a hot vehicle, the temperature about 26 degrees, he died. Now they're doing an autopsy to try to determine if it was the heat or something else.
Mm-hmm.
Again, was left, and they think for quite a while.
Byron Marchambeau, star rookies.
The child was actually outside of the car, but that's, we don't have details beyond that. So my assumption is that somebody saw the child in distress and got it out of the car, but it was too late.
Mm-hmm.
So again, you know, we say it every day, right? This time of year, we say it every day. You can't do that. Just don't make that mistake.
Levi Mitchell.
I get my lunch, and the car beside me, I could hear the dog barking. There was a dog barking, a little black dog in a front seat.
Chevon Olafoy, All-Stars.
Again, it was 10 o'clock. It wasn't super warm. It was parked in shade, but I thought to myself, you're willing to do it right now.
Yeah.
When else are you willing to do it?
Well, the other thing too is, we talk about this, people make mistakes or forget, and I understand that, but it's still something you have to guard against. But there is also the idea that
Drew Tate, Calgary Stampeders, game jersey.
You never know what could happen. You could be delayed, you could be...
Hopefully he gets a job. There's lots of jobs out there for backups.
When you think about the number of times you've said to yourself, well, I'm waiting because this happened, right? You didn't know that this was going to happen. And it happens to individuals every day.
Base pack.
And the consequences can be dire in the case of... Just don't leave a living thing in your car. It's just really as simple as that. I'm sorry to sound luxury, but a child lost their life here.
Yeah, Mark says temperature does not matter. You never leave a child. You have that conversation, I think, in the winter time, and about, you know, leaving the kids in the car.
Base pack.
You're running to grab a thing of milk and kind of school. And it's like, how many times have, you know, parents done that? They don't want to.
Base pack. Carl of West, star rookies.
Have you ever had to phone the AMA because you lost your keys in the car? You know, that just things happen, right? And you can't participate in the game, dude.
Yeah, so anyway, just again...
Another Chris Van Zeyl.
This is interesting.
Triple color.
Yesterday, we talked about Morgan Freeman
Back to back.
On the SkyTrain in Vancouver as a part of a visa campaign.
Yeah, they were launching nice. The tap pay on for what do they call it? Their SkyLink.
And so again, it wasn't Vancouver City that was paying for the voicing. It was Visa.
Solom and Aluminium. AC Lines.
I think it's important to remember. I heard a number of people saying, you know, on a couple of different shows, oh, I wonder how much that costs. And yeah,
this Chris Ackie, Star Rookies.
But a day after they announce it, they're now putting a pause on it. Well, they are because allegations have surfaced, and it was pure timing. Of course, it honestly had nothing to do with this because there's other bigger stories about Morgan Freeman.
So,
pure coincidence, allegations from at least 8 individuals, women, suggesting that Morgan Freeman, there's serious allegations against him, suggesting that he had sexually harassed
John Cornish All Stars.
8 different women, one of which is the entertainment reporter for CNN, and she was the co-author of the article.
Didn't he, like,
so as a result of that,
his granddaughter or something, or stepdaughter or something, he's had issues before.
Originally saying that.
John Chicks, Sketch and Rough Riders.
And now sort of saying, well, you know, if there was something I did that, you know, then, and I don't know, well, I guess, you know, sometimes with older individuals, and this is the way I am, although I'm a young old, I think sometimes older individuals don't understand what sexual harassment looks like.
Manny Arsenault, BC Lions All Stars.
Yeah. I think what they're not excusing that. No. I'm saying they need to educate themselves.
That's right. And I think, you know, so many times have changed, and what was acceptable 30, 40 years ago is certainly not acceptable anymore. Right. I mean, you would, you know, waitress would walk away and smack her on the bottom or right. Whatever it is. I mean, that's not,
or for that matter, even common.
Jacob Ruby, Star Rookies.
Right? Yeah. I mean, it's interesting, the Me Too movement and everything that's happened in the last little while. You may not agree with it, but this is the change, and I personally welcome it. This is the change that's happening. You have to embrace it. That strike down in Vegas.
Marcus Henry, Ottawa Redblacks.
To a great extent is about this as well. I mean, it's everywhere now, and we have to, us old guys especially, have to re-educate ourselves. We've been wrong, and we just have to accept that. Comments are not welcome, glares and are not welcome. They're just not welcome, and you may not like that, and you may think it was a simpler time.
Ted Laurent.
But it's a different time, and we have to accept that.
Yeah, one woman who worked with Freeman said the actor subjected her to sexually charged comments and unwanted touches on a near daily basis, like trying to lift up her skirt, acting like she was wearing underwear. Yeah, so, you know, things like that. Didn't comment on the bodies.
Dexter McCoyle.
That not to wear any tops that would show our breasts, not to wear anything that would show our bottoms, meaning not wearing clothes that were fitted. So, yeah, anyway, again, not to...
Do you know what else is changing is the fact that I think women in general are starting to understand that they need to...
Weston Dressler.
And stand up, yeah.
Well, and it's hard. And it's hard to do because you don't want to make a scene. You right. don't want to.
You're in last pack of the spots.
And there's one story with regard to Morgan Freeman, and it's to me the most interesting one, that he asked an individual woman, how do you feel about sexual harassment?
Base pack.
And she was so surprised by the question that she said, trying to make light of it, I don't mind it. And he turned to the other man in the room and said, that's how you do it. And this is all allegedly. Right?
Chevon Walker, autograph card out of this. Another Chris Van Zeyl jersey card.
Just in general,
right? And Drew Tate and to finish it off. So
women need to stand up.
Finally got another autograph card. No patch again yet. Hopefully the last two boxes up hold on. Thanks for guys watching. Thanks guys for watching. Have a good day.